speak up against anti-Semitic and other hate speech or acts wherever they occur. This is true around the world. It is true when anti-Semitic incidents occur in Europe, and it is true when the EU delegation in Tel Aviv is vandalized, as was recently the case. The political climate generally has become rougher, more polarized. It is all the more important for institutions, leaders, politicians to do everything in their power to build bridges and support dialogue between opposing parties in Europe as much as in Israel or any other democracy. We are a few days away from the Jewish New Year, and so I wish everybody in the room Shana Tova Vemetuka.
Madame von Schnurbein, thank you very much indeed for your presentation. I think it is time for another European voice. I would like to ask Rabbi Menachem Margolin to take the floor.
Excellencies, members of the European Parliament that are hosting us today, MEP Basescu, MEP Asima Kupolo and MEP Fodigar, thank you very much for hosting us here at the European Parliament today, and thank you for all your help. Also, with your permission, I just would like to mention our friends and colleagues who are making this event happen. I want to thank very much APA and EGA team and colleagues Tal, Alex, Daphna, Ruth, Misha, and Katya, and the other colleagues who are currently in Israel right now with another delegation. Thank you very much for making this event a successful one. A special welcome to the Minister Gilad Erdan for all the efforts and resources that its ministry do in the fight against anti-Semitism and the legitimation of Israel and the Jewish people, and all the efforts were done in order to be with us here today. I also would like to welcome especially U.S. Special Envoy to monitor and combat anti-Semitism, Mr. Alan Carr, for making the effort to come here today and bringing with him the absolute commitment of the United States of America to the fight against anti-Semitism and the delegitimation of Israel. I would like also to acknowledge and thank Mrs. Katharina von Schnuber, the EU coordinator for combating anti-Semitism, that since she is in power, we must say that we see a significant change in the policy of the European Commission in regards to leading activities against anti-Semitism. Dear friends, members of the European Parliament, diplomats, ambassadors from all over Europe, thank you very much for being here with us today. Earlier today, we were speaking with a group of senior journalists from all over Europe, and with your permission, I would like to repeat some of the things that we said to the journalists. We told them, and we tell you right here today, we need your help. We need the help of each of you. I know that many times people ask themselves, what does the Jews want? Do they really suffer? They have a strong country. They are doing well. They are successful. Well, from time to time, someone says something about what is that? Why is that that the Jews always complain? So I want to tell you that we do not complain for no reason. We complain because to be Jewish in Europe, it is very difficult. It is not by mistake that many Jews left Europe. This is not by mistake that we need to guard our synagogues and the kosher restaurants and schools and kindergarten. This is not by mistake that Jewish people have to watch their backs when they go in Paris, Frankfurt, Berlin, or everywhere in Europe. This is not by mistake. The fact is that to be a Jew in Europe, in some cases, it is dangerous. Of course, for someone who wear Jewish symbols, such as kippah or beard. And this doesn't make any sense. We see thousands of incitements against Jews every year, all over Europe. There's always almost no country in Europe that we can say the Jews could feel completely safe, besides very few of them. Instead of seeing the level of anti-Semitism decreasing every year, as it's supposed to be, it would be expected from such an important issue with a global consensus, we would expect to see decrease. But to the contrary, every year we see an increase with the level of anti-Semitism today. There are different reasons for it, but as the minister rightly said, one of the main responsible movements for the rise of anti-Semitism in Europe is the BDS movement that unfortunately supported by many European countries. And this is a real absurd. Because you see, governments have power. As long as governments are committed to fight against anti-Semitism, government can do it with a clear legislation, with a tough enforcement policy, zero tolerance towards anti-Semitism, and education, and you will not be able to see anti-Semitism. Anti-Semitism are people that don't want to be arrested, they don't want to be blamed, they would like to live like everyone else, most of them, and exactly like in most cases when the countries are strong in regards to any other criminals, if European would be more tough in regards to anti-Semitism, you would see decrease every year. But you do not see the decrease because mainly of the BDS movement. Now, let me say it very clearly. BDS movement responsible for the vast majority of attacks against Jews in Europe. Thousands of incitement, thousands of people were attacked in Europe, either verbally or physically, were by people that are influenced by BDS, that supported by European governments. They made the life of Jews in Europe as almost impossible. BDS perhaps were not very successful in boycotting the state of Israel. But to be very honest with you, they do not feel so bad about that. Because BDS movement is not about boycotting Israel. BDS movement is not a movement that supports Palestinian fight. Because BDS movement basically harm Palestinians who lose their job because of Israeli factories that close down because of the BDS. And they do not care about the Palestinians. BDS movement do not care that the European Commission is against boycotting Israel because BDS is a movement that has only one important mission, which is to make anti-Semitism in Europe a legitimate fight. And they succeed, unfortunately. They succeed to make anti-Semitism something that today is in the mainstream. It's not only the young people in this country and another country. Today is in the mainstream. In the Morgan newspaper that was published just some weeks ago, someone criticized the state of Israel. He has full right to criticize the state of Israel. But adding that we cannot think that a God will give an ugly noise to his people, you cannot call it just a fair criticize against Israel. And this is what we are here for. BDS movement is a movement that should be boycotted by Europe. The fact is that Russian citizens in Europe, Chinese citizens in Europe, or Turkish citizens in Europe are not attacked because of the policies of their government. There are many Ukrainians who could feel they're not so happy with the Russian policy. But did anyone see so ever a Russian person in London or Brussels who were attacked because of Putin's policy? Did anyone see any Chinese here in Brussels who is attacked because of China policy in Hong Kong or in other conflict territory? We do not see it, but we see almost every day, and I'm also a personal evidence, to a Jew walking in Brussels experience anti-Semitic just because officially the policy of the State of Israel. So as Minister Erdogan presented to you today the mask should be removed. And therefore we urge you today, diplomats and ambassadors from all over Europe, anti-Semitism is not a political subject. This is a dangerous epidemic. So we ask you for your help to spread the truth and bring this information to your respective government to make sure that all of them will recognize BDS as it is, an organization that supports terror, an organization that is the biggest incitement against Jews in Europe. And that will absolutely bring to a positive change in the life of the Jews in Europe and will allow the continuation of the Jewish community in Europe and its prosperity. Thank you very much.
Rabbi, thank you very much indeed for your speech. Now I would kindly ask Mr. Ilan Carr, U.S. Coordinator for Combating Anti-Semitism, to take the floor.
Thank you so much, Minister Fotyga. I had the pleasure of flying here from Warsaw, where I presented the official U.S. position on anti-Semitism at the Human Dimension Implementation Meetings, and I appreciate Poland's hospitality. I also